I welcome you to another day in my life video. Let's go ahead and roll that morning footage. Yes, welcome to another day in my life video. I'm glad that you're here. We'll see again what today consists of. I have pretty acne-prone skin. I've struggled with acne ever since like middle school, I think. Anyways, so I got a new product and I wanted to share it with you guys for some of you who may struggle with acne-prone skin, all that good stuff, not having a clear complexion, which I totally understand the frustration. First thing is this product, which I've had this product for a while. Well, I'm starting to use it again, but it's the Cetaphil Pro Derma Control Oil Removing Foam Wash. It looks like so. Nice, there we go. Looks like that. Foaming face wash. Oh my gosh. A foaming face wash. So I recommend that if you're like, just getting rid of acne. I understand. So anyways, the new product that I wanted to tell you guys about, because I was excited to find it, and I have it on right now, but it's a Cetaphil Redness Relieving Daily Facial Moisturizer with Sunscreen SPF 20 for redness prone skin. I think I already said that. But it's a tinted formula. It looks like so. Has a little squishy thing that, applicator. But I really like it. Anyways, I wanted to share that with you guys because if any of you guys needed help with your skin or anything like that. I actually did a video quite a while ago. You can check it out. I think I talked about some of these products actually. And also, if you have, I think my red skin tone also goes into my hands. But so I have super dry hands and they're red all the time. So this is the O'Keeffe's Working Hands. But it's in like the bottle, not the, you're like scraping it out, So yeah, I also really like this. So there we go. Some products for you to try. Perhaps if you're struggling with skin breakouts and things, or
dry hands in this cold weather.
So let me show you a book I've been reading. And I really also kind of find it strange that I'm filming this in the bathroom. Mainly that's because of the products I was going to show you in the bathroom, so I just kind of went with it. This is Mrs. Oswald Chambers, the book that I'm reading now. It's a super sweet book. I love hearing about their love story and their life for Christ. It's pretty amazing, so very good book. I will see you in the next clip.
This is where it's at, my friends. Premium Roast Mint Cafe.
Alright, so what I think I'm gonna do now is clean up the room a little bit so I can get started on some schoolwork. So yeah, I think that's what in the world is going on with my hair? That looks like a dinosaur. So I'm gonna start cleaning up the room. And play. So now I'm gonna do some schoolwork. I have my laptop here and everything, and then if I get bored or anything, or take a break, do schoolwork, take a break or whatever, I have some watercolor. So we'll see. I may do some watercolor some point today, but otherwise I'm just trying to get some schoolwork done. I think I have a discussion post due tomorrow, so I need to get on that and also watch some math videos and stuff like that. I also reheated my coffee, so I got that here. And then this is my watercolor jar. Shout out to my friend Ella for making this for me. So yeah, that's pretty much what I'm up to right now. I may actually light a candle to set the mood. So I have this trail mix, but I'm wondering what you guys think about trail mix without M&Ms or any kind of sweet thing. I don't know.
I have some good spicy trail mix.
But if you got yourself some berries and nuts trail mix without any M&Ms, I don't know, it's just not really my favorite. But I don't eat it anyways. I'd enjoy it. Alright, so it is 11:30. Let's check what the lighting situation is here. And I think I'm gonna try and make me something for lunch. In my life, I made some gourmet pasta. Enjoying this video so far. My discussion post for class, I go to Liberty University Online, and it was about, it's called SERVE, and it has like, it's kind of like an acronym of sharing the gospel with others and, you know, examining those around you and how you can best encourage those around you and kind of getting out of your comfort zone and different things like that. I think it was vacate your comfort zone because of the V. But so that's what I was doing in there. I don't even know what I'm gonna eat for lunch. Perhaps some ding dongs or something. I hope you guys have been enjoying the Better Than Coffee Wednesday pick-me-ups. Have you watched the last one? I don't know, have you? Be sure to check it out. I'm gonna make me some lunch. Chicken fries for the win, my lad. Oof, look at them little thingies. So I'm just sitting here. I just watched a math video and I'm done with the videos. But what I feel like, I just wanna pop on here real quick and just, I was just thinking that, you know, sometimes during the day we get a little overwhelmed. We start worrying about things. We start thinking about things and we get just a little distraught or, you know, just discouraged. And for me, I've just really been finding it to be encouraging just to stop what I'm doing and just pull out God's word and just read some of it. More often than not, maybe the Psalms or Proverbs or something like that, just to kind of refocus a little bit and just to pray, take a deep breath, and just calm my heart a little bit by reading his word. So I don't know, I'm about to do that here, and so I just wanted to pop on here and share that because I think that it really does help. And it's easy to want to do other things like get on social media or watch videos or kind of ignore it or try to do something else that's not gonna fill what you really need. Only God can satisfy all your needs. Everything is met in him. And so yeah, I just want to share that with you guys. About to do some exercises, which is something I enjoy doing, is exercising. So I wanted to show you guys a quick leg exercise move that you can do with if you have a resistance band. Now this one here my sister got for me for Christmas, and it's pretty hardcore. The other ones I've had of like
ripped them and they are rubbery and they're thin. So this one's pretty heavy duty. But anyways, resistance band of your choosing. And I'm gonna show you guys a leg workout idea. Let me see if I'm in, if I'll be in. Okay, so you're pretty much doing a wall sit. So here I am, wall sit position. And you're gonna be doing a wall sit. At the same time, you're gonna make sure your legs are out. And then while you're doing that, you're gonna be one, two, you can do how many you want. I do like four of them. And then I'll go down, don't touch the floor, and then push yourself up the wall and then kind of squeeze, I guess. And then you just do that, I don't know, until it really burns and you can't do another one, but then you do another one. So one, two, and hold it like wall position so that it burns even more when you do this. And down. There you have it, a leg workout idea for you to try. At the beginning of the video, that's how we do. I can't really move my eyebrows very well, but is it gonna? All right, so I've had this idea for a while for a kind of, ignore my hair, I took it out of the bun, but kind of like a behind, like what Godzilla Breadcrumbs means, and I've had a few ideas for a while of how to go about it, and so I'm finally trying to make this video, and you'll just have to wait and see. Hopefully I will finish it, but her name is Jo Malo, that is her name. And I put a wig on for it, so that's why I'm putting my hair in a low bun for this character. Jo Malo. Remember that name. Remember the name. So anyways, I'll put the wig on for you here. So I had to put my hair down. Give me a flag. My mom dressed up for school or something, and that's how she got the wig. So first, she has hair. Yeah. So she has this blonde hair and it's, you know, bangs. I think my mom cut the bangs or something. Anyways, she has this kind of hair. And then she has glasses. These are also my mom's glasses. And then she wears a robe. So that's Jo Malo. And hopefully y'all will see this video soon. I'm not sure when, but, and hopefully it puts a smile to somebody's face. So yeah, Jo Malo, everybody. Woo, it's me, Jo. Well, hello everyone. It is actually Sunday when I'm ending this vlog. So I'm editing the vlog and I realized I didn't close off. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. That last clip, I realized that even if I don't end up using that for a future video, or it just may be a while before that video is up, I hope it made someone smile, regardless of what happens in the future with that video. So anyways, thank you guys again so much for watching. I hope to see you guys next time, perhaps, I don't know. Make sure you're subscribed, and yeah, I hope you have a wonderful day.